Good morning, dear students, the students of class 5. I think all of you are familiar with the term coronavirus. Please follow the disciplinary rules, be safe and keep social distancing so that you and yourself, family as well as the nation is free from this deadly coronavirus. And the most important thing, you should not forget your studies. Today I am going to start the first chapter, that is the subject computer. Now the students of class 5, see the chapter name is given as evolution of computers. The meaning is, see, the computer or the laptop which we are using nowadays, the small ones which you can carry in your school bag, but the development of this size was not so easy as it seems to be. Today's computer, what we are using, either it is a laptop or a desktop, it is extensively used everywhere. So the computers are used extensively in banks, hospitals, media, entertainment industries, schools, homes, space technology, research, railways, airports and so on. Nowadays we cannot say a place where we don't find the application of computer. So the term computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. So the computer can perform any kind of work very, very fast. Now we'll go back to the history of computers. Now this is the early calculating device, which is known as abacus. Abacus was the first mechanical device for calculation developed in China. It was made up of wooden frames with rods having beads, and it is divided into two parts, heaven and earth, and the drawing is given here. Nowadays in some of the sports shop you find this abacus, which is very, very helpful for calculation. Next is coming as Pascal's calculator. Now Pascal calculator, so, or the Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, invented an adding machine called Pascal calculator or Pascaline in the year 1642. These dates are very, very important. So you see the drawing of the Pascaline given over here. It is used gears, wheels and dials. Numbers are displayed by rotating the wheels, for capable of being addition, subtraction. The gear principle, numbers are displayed by rotating the wheels. The gear principle was further employed in mechanical calculators. The next device is coming as Leibniz calculator. The famous German mathematician improved the Pascal's machine in 1671. So this machine is more useful. It can perform multiplication, division and find square roots. Next important machine is difference engine or analytical engine, was developed by Charles Babbage, who is also known as the father of computers. Now difference engine was developed in 1822 and analytical engine in 1833. Analytical engine has a different five units, such as input, output, store, meal and the control, and all these have a small function of its own. Next is coming as the Boolean logic, or in the higher classes being taught as a Boolean algebra. So George Boole was an English mathematician. He realized the complex mathematical problems could be solved by reducing them to a series of questions having either positive or negative answers. So he was the first person to develop the concept of one and zeros. The next machine known as tabulating machine was developed by Harmon Hollyett, an American statistician, invent a machine called tabulating machine, capable of reading data, processing it, giving the desired output. The input was given through punch cards. Now next is coming as Mark I was developed by Howard Eichen, an engineer working in IBM, in the year 1944. Next coming as ENIAC.
ENIAC, the full form is Electronic Numerical Integrator and Calculator. This full form is very important, developed by John Macaulay and John Presser Eckert in 1946. And this machine consists of 118,000 vacuum tubes, which works much faster than Mark 1. Next is coming as next machine is known as EDSAC. The full form is Electronic Delay Storage Automatic Calculator, developed in the year 1949. Now the next machine, EDVAC. The full form is Electronic Discrete Variable Automatic Computer. So this is another calculating device which was developed jointly by John von Neumann, Press Eckert, John Macaulay in the year 1950, which this machine is much developed than EDVAC. And the EDVAC concept of storing different programs on punch card led to the development of advanced computers that we know today. Next important machine is UNIVAC 1. Full form is Universal Automatic Computer 1. Was the first commercially available computer, means the common people can afford it, designed by Press Eckert John Macaulay in 1951. So this is much more easier to handle, where the data can be stored. Now these computers, the computers what we are using, can also be further classified in the generation of computer. Generation of computer means which will lead back to the history. History means from this year to another year, means a range of years where it is divided. First generation computers. So it is from 1940 to 56. Now, so here we have so many features are there. The important features, the important keywords I have underlined. Now, first generation computers were based on vacuum tubes. This is the most important. Computers, second, the computers use magnetic tapes to store data. Machine language was used. Inputs were given through punch card or paper tapes. Outputs was displayed as printouts. And the few names of the computers are UNIVAC, ENIAC, EDVAC. Now next, second generation computers, the year is starting from 1956 to 63. In second generation, the vacuum tubes are replaced by Now, in second generation, some more features are like use of magnetic tapes, development of programming languages like Fortran, COBOL, basic languages came into existence. Punch card, use of paper tapes, and the machine developed at this time like IBM 1400, IBM 350, etc. Next, in the third generation computers, starting from the year 1964 to 1971. Now in the third generation mark the use of integrated circuit. Integrated circuit means where many electronic devices are combined together. Use of magnetic tapes, development of the languages like Pascal, RPG, the size of the computer got reduced, more storage capacity, more calculation speed, and more reliability, use of keyboard, monitor, printer, etc., and the development of the machines. Next, in the fourth generation, which starting from the year 1972 till this, as it's going on, so the development of VLS SIC, or which is known as a microprocessor, latest one, or the series which are developed from the Intel, starting from i3, i5, i7, i7 is the latest processor. Fourth generation led to the development of better monitor, printer, microprocessor, etc. The computers are portable, more reliable, cheapest, so it got reduced. Now the few computers developed are like Apple, Macintosh, IBM PC, etc. Now in the fifth generation, so the fifth generation marked by the development of artificial intelligence, or short form as AI, where the computers can behave or think and react the same way as human do. Now in the fifth generation computers, so these computers are still in the development stage, or we can say the use of robots. Robots are being used in some difficult situations. So this robot is also a part of the fifth generation computers. Then coming as characteristic. Characteristics means what are the important features of a computer. Now, so we have many features. So let us discuss these features one by one. First is regarding the speed. So all of you are familiar that computer can do any calculations very quickly. Within few seconds, it can do a big calculation. So speed is the amount of time taken by computer in completing the task. Next is coming as accuracy. Accuracy means the answer what the computer gives is always correct. Refers to the degree of perfection of operations performed by a computer. So computer performs all the calculations without doing any errors, capable of handling large calculations or huge amount of data, can be processed quickly and accurately. Now next topic is coming as reliability. Reliability means whatever the answers the computer displays, always it is correct. So at one first chance we can say that it is always correct without any failure. Next is coming as versatility. The term versatility means that a computer, the machine, you find its application in any field, either it is an education, science, technology, business, finance, accounts, or any other areas, computer can work of its own. Next feature coming as storage. Storage means the capacity of a computer to store data. Now, in the computer, we have primary memory, secondary memory. Primary memory such as RAM and ROM. The secondary memory such as hard disk, CD, pen drive, etc., where the data can be stored for future reference. Next feature is coming as diligence. Diligence means a computer can work 24 hours without getting tired. As the human beings, so at the night if we feel sleepy, but computer can work long hours without getting tired. Next is meaning as multitasking. Now whenever we use the term as multitasking, means computer can perform many functions or many jobs at the same time. Like you can listen to a music at the same time, you can do the work of MS Paint. Now the last part is coming as limitations of a computer, like incapability to think. Now incapability to think means like human beings, the computer and electronic machine cannot think or take the decision of its own. In case of error, it cannot take alternative action. The next second is no intelligence, like computer has no IQ. Computer will work as per the instructions given by the user. It will not take ahead, or it will not do anything extra of its own. Dependence on power means, suppose if there is no electricity or there is a shortage of power, we cannot use the computer. Now so we come to the end of the chapter. Now here we have this brain developer objective type questions, like fill in the blanks, state true and false, match the following, application based questions. Dear students, make sure you write all these in your copies. When the school reopens, we'll check it. Then multi choice, answer the following. So under the answer the following, we have total 4 questions are there, which are to be written in your computer copy only. After that, if you have any doubts, you please write your doubts in the comment section. Thank you.